Braddock back in 1937 in Chicago. And he defended his crown, as you know, 15 times more than Jack Johnson, 19 more than Jack Dempsey, and 21 times more than Jim Jeffries. And great champions like John L. Sullivan, Jim Corbett, and Bob Fitzsimmons defended their crowns once were then dethroned. By the way, the action in the ring right now, as you see, is the midget who has come into the ring. And as he's in there, wandering across, the boys are saying, throw him out, throw him out. So the excitement, of course, is always attendant upon one of these great little pieces of side play. And, of course, they are the bow.
Introducing from Cincinnati, Ohio, wearing black trunks, weighing 184.5 pounds, Ezzard Charles. Charles. His opponent from Detroit, Michigan, wearing purple trunks, weighing 218, Joe Lewis. Lewis. 15 rounds for the heavyweight championship of the world.
Now, as you look at the center of the ring, there's the usual huddle as Joe Lewis and his managers and trainers take their orders from Mark Hahn.
I'm familiar with the rules of this state, and I'm here to see that you box according to those rules. Be careful of your body blows. A low blow may cost you the round. If you score a knockdown, go to the corner to which I send you and stay there until I tell you to come out and resume fighting. In close, I want you to punch with both hands free. When I see you clinching there, I'm going to tell you to stop punching, and I want you both to stop punching on the break and step back clean. Now shake hands and good luck to both of you.
Well, you know, officially a championship bout with no champion in it is what you're looking at tonight. The winner, however, will be recognized in New York and by the NBA as the world champion. You're going to see the famous Joe Lewis in his famous fighting style, and an Ezzard Charles, who is a cobra and a striking puncher with hand always held high. As a different Lewis. He's not out to counterpunch, he's out to end it. 36 years of age, his opponent 29. Lewis with his back to you. Ezzard Charles, easily identifiable with the stripe, the white stripe down his trunks. To go of the first round, and there's excitement and action. A goodly crowd here tonight, and you can hear them in our Pabst Blue Ribbon microphone. This is a Lewis who constantly stalks, as you know. Charles has Joe's nose just slightly colored, but Joe is in there to punch. £33 difference in favor of Lewis. 218 to 184 and a half. Notice how Charles keeps that right high up to his chin to shoot it out in case he has to. Crafty, agile, excellent boxer. 1 minute to go, first round. Joe tried for the punch that time. They may talk about Lewis's reflexes being slow, but his punch is still there. Half a minute to go of the first round. Although Charles is considered rather light for a heavyweight at his weight of 184.5. Remember that Bob Fitzsimmons weighed 156.5 for his championship fight with Jim Corbett back in 1897. Now, as we follow Lewis back to his corner, the crowd roared for the exciting action of the first round. Joe Lewis, as you know, and perhaps you don't, so I'll remind you, has fought 61 bouts in his career. This is his 62nd. He has never fought a preliminary. He won 60 of those fights, lost only one. That was the knockout to Max Schmeling. Knocked out 52 of his opponents. Never fought a draw. Now let's go over and take a look at Ezzard Charles. Ezzard Charles, at 184.5, has fought 73 fights. He's won 67 of them. He's lost five. He drew one. He was knocked out but once in his life, as was Joe Lewis. And he KO'd 43 of his opponents. Now there's the 10-second warning whistle. Round two. And we'll see what's going to happen. Comments around here indicate they're all waiting to see what's going to happen. Both with those beautiful lefts. One off a counter by Charles, which is unusual. And now they're punching. Sentimental crowd with Joe Lewis and delighted that he is forcing fighting rather than waiting for the counter punching. And Charles hitting. I think the exciting comment is that Ezzard Charles does not seem the least bit frightened of Joe Lewis's great prowess. Well, there's the first of the combinations that worked, and Lewis landed that right hand with 2 minutes to go of round two. Lewis seems much younger than his 36 years, the way he's going in these first two rounds. I don't know what his plan of action is, but it certainly has proven that he wants to get out and enter it as fast as he can. Many years ago in the Billy Kahn fight, Lewis said, "I'll box him and then knock him out." He's boxing Ezzard Charles tonight. They are punching each other, and the blows are telling and they're landing. One minute to go of the second round. And the crowd likes this one because this is really a good fight. Charles hasn't changed his style. He's beating Lewis a bit to the punches. Half a minute to go of the second round, and most everyone is now on the edge of their seats. They didn't quite expect it to be this good so early. They're talking up around the ringside. The comments are all indicating exactly as we're passing it on to you. The round is almost over. And there it is, the bell ending round two. Lewis won 54 bouts, 43 by knockouts. Charles was never beaten in the amateur ranks. He won every tournament he ever entered, about 12 in all. Here we go, round three. Lewis, imperturbable. Charles, exactly the same, but always willing to lead. Despite the craftiness and the agility and the fluency, Charles is constantly wary of the devastating power of the Joe Louis punch. His excellent pictures show you that Charles is able to reach Joe, and Joe is looking for that tag. Two minutes to go, round three. There it is. An almost slip by Charles that time, and the crowd saw it, but Joe delayed. Superb fighting machine that has been Joe Louis is superb again tonight. Charles slowing just a bit now in his actions. Remember that no heavyweight champion has ever regained his title, although in this case, Joe Louis gave it away, didn't lose it in the ring. Yet no heavyweight champion has ever won it back again. Charles is matching them with him now. One minute to go, round three. Joe's face is just a bit redder than it was when he came into the ring from those left hooks that flick out and land and the rights that cross over. But Joe dramatically always moving in. Excellent to see them not clinching, always breaking their own clinches. Half a minute to go, the third round. Joe Louis, Ezzard Charles, and Pabst mighty happy to bring you all the action so that you can see it. Charles is willing to bury his leaves, left or right as the case may be. He loves to hit with that right. There's the end of round three. And you know something? Well, this broadcast tonight is making great history. Never before has an event been heard or seen by so many people. Not only here in America, but right around the globe. It's being shortwaved to Australia and New Zealand, 10,000 miles away, to Latin America and Little America, and to our armed forces wherever they may be. Well, we're ready to go into action in round four. Most fans consider Joe Louis' KO of Max Schmeling in 2:04 of the first round the quickest in a heavyweight championship bout. But that's not so. Back in 1908, a bout was ended in a neat 1:28 by Australian Tommy Burns. Well, the pattern of the fight hasn't changed. Louis, 33 and a half pounds heavier, 7 years older. Cincinnati Cobra keeps moving in at him. Then the right, in case you missed it. And the crowd roared, for Louis struck out like the cobra that Charles is reputed to be. 2 minutes to go, the fourth round. Startled but not hurt, Charles maintains his poise. Joe's always looking for that opening. Most of the fight experts felt that Charles would cut Joe Louis. But there are no marks on either fighter. That's the first indication that Charles was backing up, and backing up cautiously. One minute to go of the fourth round. There's Joe Louis striking out now. Crowd groans when Joe holds back with an opening, quite apparent to everyone. It's a different Joe Louis, missing three blows in a row. Half a minute to go of the fourth round. Joe looks more severe than I've seen him in the whole fight. His reflexes work. See him dance away that time on the feint? Charles perceptibly seems tired. That is, tired of taking a punishment. The round's almost over. You'll hear Joe Bannon ring the bell. And that ends the fourth round of the heavyweight championship bout, which has startled the imagination of all who are here, as we have gone four rounds now and await the bell and the whistle for the fifth. Here in Yankee Stadium, we've got the usual buzzing excitement that attends a World's Championship boxing bout. As I told you earlier, the celebrities are here in great numbers, and they include the familiar names of people who are always at sporting exhibitions of this sort. The great names of the newspaper world, swelled by a great number who are in the East for the forthcoming World Series, and all by plenty who are convention-bound in the great metropolis. I remind you that Joe Louis weighed in today at 218, the heaviest he's ever been for a heavyweight championship bout, and Ezzard Charles tipped the scales at 184.5, giving Joe Louis a weight advantage of 33.5 pounds. Although he is spotting, as I've told you, his arrival exactly 7 years in youth. So far, the rounds have seemed to distribute themselves. We have the Ezzard Charles striking out, willing to match with Joe Louis, the Joe Louis stalking and not trudging backwards, but always stalking, round five. Charles always seems stronger in the first minute and a half of any round. And something seems to set him back so that he can look Joe over to see perhaps what damage he's done, if any. And there he is. Throwing those blows. And he's connecting with Joe, but not too cleanly. He hasn't got the solid punch that we know Joe has or had. But he mixes. Well, you can put the seal of approval on this bout so far, just as you'd like to put that Pabst Blue Ribbon seal right in front of you on the table. Yes, sir. 2 minutes to go in round number five. Ezzard Charles with the lighter stripe down his trunks. Now, as we notice, the round is half over, and Charles begins to slow down. Now, whether he's looking to see what's going on or what to do about his patterns, I don't know. But Louis has his combinations working when they're working, and he's willing to set them in. Charles has been striking the cleaner blows this round, and Louis's have been glancing. Neither boy is marked. We've 1 minute to go of round five. The big thing I'm looking for is to see whether Louis slows down, whether he gets down off his heels and stays down, even in that famous plodding style. The first indication that age may be taking its toll. Louis waiting to get in, but Charles still flailing away. Half a minute to go of round five. Undeniably, both superbly set up, in perfect conditioning and with the proper equipment for boxing. Louis continues to stalk. The round is almost over. Joe almost connected just as round five ended.
Stay tuned for more action tonight at the Fights on Classic Sports Network. You're in a nightmare filled with monsters that fight, that crawl, that kill. Welcome to Predators of the Wild, an intense journey through a real-life chamber of horrors from Time Life Video. Face creatures so fearsome only the brave dare get close enough to film them. Seem so close, they will make your skin crawl. Call this toll-free number now and begin your journey to the shadow world with Giant Tarantula, yours for just $9.99. Confront a spider that measures a foot across and has venom so powerful it dissolves its victims from the inside out. Other videos take you deeper into the shadow world. Get Giant Tarantula for just $9.99. Keep only the tapes you want. There's never a commitment to buy. So call now and stare into the eyes of a monster.
To order Predators, call 1-800-297-4411. That's 1-800-297-4411. Or send $9.99 plus $3.49 shipping and handling to Predators, P.O. Box 2727, Department CSN, Costa Mesa, California.
Welcome back to Tonight at the Fights on Classic Sports Network.
Round six is now about to come up. Might tell you that Jim Jeffries came out of 5 years retirement a long while ago to meet Jack Johnson at Reno in 1910. He was age 35 and Johnson knocked him out. Here we have Lewis out of retirement fighting the NBA heavyweight champion, Joe Lewis, the undefeated former heavyweight champion of the world, trying to do what no man before him has done, win back his title. And now he's aggressive as he's meeting a very aggressive, lighter opponent. The pattern has changed a bit now. Now in close, I see that Lewis is beginning to develop a mouse under his left eye. Yes, there it is, quite apparent. No obvious markings on Charles. 2 minutes to go in the sixth round. Joe's beginning to breathe a bit now. Close here at the ringside, we can see that. Now, Mark Kahn constantly staying out of the way. Has very little to do as the third man in the ring. Both these boys, superbly clean fighters. The pattern has changed enough so that we see a mauling round now instead of the long-distance clean fighting. And amazingly, Charles is willing to stay in with Joe Lewis. Now, let's see. Lewis, I think, has perceptibly slowed down, but Charles has, in a sense, too. 1 minute ago of the sixth round of the heavyweight championship out here at Yankee Stadium in New York City. Brought to you with the good wishes of Pabst Blue Ribbon Beer. Yowza, yowza. Well, here they are right over our microphone. And the exchanges are terrifying. Joe's willing to strike, but he's missing. And the lighter opponent wrestled him away that time. Half a minute to go of the sixth round, and Charles is dropping his right hand, which normally he keeps very high as protection. That may be an indication. Joe's noticed it. Round is almost over. Well, here we've definitely seen something tonight. We see one pattern in which a lighter opponent has been striking out with the best force possible to try to, in the best essence of his cobra style, cut up Joe Lewis, aging as he is, and to slow his reflexes down to the very lowest point. On the other hand, Joe Lewis, having started the fight with an aggressive amount of boxing ability, trying to get to his lighter opponent to score that punch which will slow him down. Charles, as you recognize, has been spinning Lewis beautifully when in trouble, And despite the fact that he slows down, as I have witnessed in the 1 minute and a half after the round begins, he has nevertheless been able to watch everything that Joe Louis has been doing. Here we go for round seven. One other observation. I noticed that Louis didn't like the feel of the ice pack on his eye. And now you see Charles is striking for that eye. There's the pattern for this round. There he goes, hitting in there constantly. And Louis's eye is beginning to develop a tremendous closing. It's almost an aperture now, slip. So we always have the spectacle of the Louis that we knew with that tremendous right, and there he threw it, and the constant application of good blows with craftiness and agility and fluency by Ezzard Charles. Two minutes to go in the seventh round of the heavyweight championship out here at Yankee Stadium in New York. A goodly crowd on hand and giving generous applause to all the exchanges. The picture reveals now the boys are going into the milling style for the round, you see, is almost half over. And Charles willingly steps away to watch what Joe Louis will do. Joe, for a second there, had Charles in trouble, but Charles weaves out of it. I think Charles has developed a mouse under his left eye, too. So they both have slightly closing left eyes. So they'll both be fighting with one eye. So it's right hand, hitting to right hand. 1 minute to go in the seventh round. And we come to the slowing process. The man, 36, but yet with the punch. The youth with 29, and yet being slowed down by punches. Charles still keeps hitting with that right. Of course, what Louis wants is Charles to come in close as he slows him down. Half a minute to go. And the crowd anticipated that was it, but Joe missed both shots. Joe keeps Charles in close. Well, what the two questions were, can the old man of 36, and I use the word old advisedly, and how good is Ezzard Charles, the question is being answered almost halfway through the fight. Round seven is almost over. And as the fight goes on, the excitement of the crowd becomes, I think, more dramatic in this respect, that they're just watching, constantly watching, to see whether Joe is going to slow down Ezzard Charles and get to him, or whether Ezzard Charles will be able to close Joe's eyes and keep flicking away at him. So far, it's been the perfect fight. There's Charles with that speed, the rapier stuff, in the first minute and a half of each round. He has excellent recuperative powers in between the rounds, and it keeps him moving for at least a minute and a half. There's Joe, now counterpunching. Joe is a little at a disadvantage with that left eye, continuing to close, so the lefts have got to be thrown with a little speculation. And so, for that matter, is Ezzard Charles. Not quite as apparent to the camera as it is to us at the ringside. Two minutes to go of the eighth round of this 15-round heavyweight championship bout here at the Yankee Stadium in New York. Charles continues to pummel away in that first minute and a half, always keeping Joe at a disadvantage, and then suddenly Joe seems to have the weight to put into Charles. So far, he hasn't leaned that weight on Charles during the fight. Here they are right over our Pabst Blue Ribbon microphone. Charles has been fighting with a greater severity and a greater amount of punching ability in this round than he has in any previous round, so perhaps that remark I made about his recuperative powers stands in good stead. One minute remains of round eight, and Joe Louis is beginning to slow down a little bit as Charles keeps punching away, and he's brought a slight touch, I think, of a fatigued look to Joe's face, and just the slightest touch of claret to his nose. So the Cincinnati Cobra is fighting for the face, fighting as he planned to fight, to cut Joe Louis up and slow him down on account of his years. And so perhaps we're seeing in this half minute remaining of the eighth round the best of the ability of Ezzard Charles, which may answer one of the questions. How good is he? The other one has yet to be answered. Can Joe come back? Round is almost over, and Joe keeps stalking as he does, right up to the bell. Shooting the short ones inside now may have a telling effect on Ezzard Charles, who evidently senses the round is at an end. Well, now, as we tabulate at the ringside, it's just a question of how the boys see it, where they sit, and what they feel. And certainly, I think the whole fight is predicated on what everybody else has known and read. Just the two questions that have to be answered, and both have to be answered at the same time. Round nine. Charles up on his toes, Joe Louis back down on his heels now. Joe Louis superbly conditioned, he had to be for this kind of a fight. Two right hands that Charles put in were the toughest two of the fight. Joe just remained erect. The two hardest, of course, by Charles. Joe put one in early in the second round, you'll remember. But he's scoring his punches at will now in the first minute and a half of this big round. 2 minutes to go in this round. Charles scoring with telling punches. Joe watching, never closing his eyes when the punch comes at him. One of the great attributes to his fighting ability. Joe is now bleeding and suddenly had a look of that tired feeling on his face. Perhaps just remarshaling his forces. But the fight is now going to the pattern the experts declared would be. Now the punches are coming at will as Charles watches to see what he can do with Louis and punches to prove it. The greatest of the great champions, with his record in the record book and the youthful aspirant to the undisputed world heavyweight crown. 1 minute to go of this round. There he is, Joe Louis at 36, Ezzard Charles at 29 years of age. Bob Fitzsimmons was 37 years old when in his first title defense he was knocked out by Jim Jeffries. Fitz, however, was 52 years old when he fought his last battle back in 1914. So we'll bring the age question to you as Charles keeps pouring it in. Starting to mangle Joe Louis's face now. And Joe Louis has brought a tremendous rush of claret from the nose of Ezzard Charles. He got one in close there. It was a left uppercut. The round is almost over, some 15 seconds to go. And that was Joe Louis getting in one of his telling punches. Charles wiping the blood away. It was a beautiful left just a moment ago. The round is almost over. And there you have Joe Louis taking a copious beating throughout the round, number nine, from Ezzard Charles, and then suddenly, in the last 25 seconds, scoring with a delightful inside left uppercut with a tremendous amount of telling impact, slowing up Ezzard Charles as the blow landed heavily and did damage to Charles's nose, which is now, of course, being treated by that capable trainer, Ray Arcel, who, as you look at the ring at this particular moment, is in there working on the left of your camera as you see the back of Ezzard Charles' head. And they let Ray Arcel do all the work. Well, there you have the spectacle again of the NBA heavyweight champion, always striking out in the first minute and a half, and then Joe Louis suddenly springing into action. And now the comments around the ringside as my ears listen are, it's not the same Joe. Well, of course, at 36 with reflexes slowing down, it still may be the same Joe. He's fought fights like this before, and suddenly when he found that opening, shot those devastating blows. Round 10 coming up. Well, with two-thirds of the fight almost gone by and both boys needing refreshments, I would presume that as I do, I would always enjoy that Pabst Blue Ribbon beer. How about you? The claret has come quickly again from Charles's nose. It's his right nostril, and Joe keeps banging away with that left. Now you have Ezzard Charles leashing and lashing. How much effect a bleeding nose will have on a fighter, I don't know. It's an annoyance, undeniably, and causes motions with the hands which should be held. So it may be that the bridge of that nose has been badly damaged. It appears that way. Joe is working on him, and Joe with a counter that time almost caught him. 2 minutes to go of the 10th round. And if anything, Joe seems to be stronger now with the advantage of having hurt his opponent. So both, because their heads are banging together, are covered with just a bit of blood. Joe is now stalking. The sight of the blood has enraged him. The crowd senses that he's after him, and that's why you hear the roar in the background. The cameras go up. Charles backing away. Joe goes in. Left eye closed, the nostril bleeding. That's why he's backing up. Joe is after him. Joe Louis. Now stalking his prey. Waiting to work those combinations off the left. In close then, the camera couldn't reveal it. A terrific short right. It landed on the button of Ezzard Charles, and he's bleeding more profusely. Joe's best round now, and the crowd roaring with it. 1 minute to go of the 10th round. Knees buckling slightly, Ezzard Charles back against the ropes that time. Joe constantly looking for that opening. This is the drama. This is where what you see tells you what you want to see. Charles beautifully spinning Joe Louis around when in trouble. Half a minute to go, the 10th round. Joe Louis showing his best. Almost 30 minutes after the fight began. So the question of 36 years of age seems to be disproven at this moment. Charles lashing back as best he can, and yet showing that agility and flexibility and fluency as the round is almost over. And they'll have to work on him and work on him hard in this corner. Here's the bell. Like all crowds, what's gone before means nothing in the memory of what Joe did in that last round. And if Charles fights back, he's certainly a match for Joe tonight. No matter the outcome, he's giving Joe a good battle. There is something that may be an indication of the end. As Joe put in a powerful punch to the body, he took two or three counter punches, two rights that were sort of loosely set to the head, so that Ezzard Charles was not disturbed and was willing to flail back. The left uppercut that time by Charles slowed Joe down. 2 minutes to go in the 11th round in what has been a good fight. And that's not giving expletives away either. Oh, Well, the crowd certainly has been roaring its approval, just as you'll approve Pabst Blue Ribbon beer. Now the minute and a half of the round has gone by, and we'll have to see whether or not this is where Charles will step backwards and allow Joe to come to him. Joe will lead and Joe will counter, and this is an unusual procedure. Joe's best weapon is left hook. Ezzard Charles, that best weapon being a left, but a following straight right, whistling for the jaw. Those who have missed this fight, I think, have missed something. 1 minute to go of the 11th round, and the procedure remains the same. Procedural-wise, Charles lets it slow down, gets to his corner and takes that recuperation. Joe's eye, his left eye is almost closed. In fact, it is, you might as well say. He has a difficult time opening it. As it, Charles' left eye is also closed. Now the blood is not flowing as it was earlier. Isn't it wonderful, in a sense, to realize that a man 33 pounds less will spin the heavyweight champion around on occasions? Condition is certainly something of a great asset here, because you see Charles lashing back now after the damage of the last round. And this round is almost at an end. It'll be the 11th round, the end of it. And much to talk about and much to figure. We'll wait for the bell. Well, there it is, the bell ending the 11th round. 12th round is now coming up. The whistle has sounded. Joe Lewis looks a little bit, perturbed in his corner. Here he comes out against Ezzard Charles. This is the slowest of the first few seconds action of any round. There's Charles starting his leads now. That's the first round I've seen him go to work at the body. Both boys completely blinded in their left eyes, attesting to the punching power of both. Both will keep punching away at those eyes. Well, there's the cleanest shot of the fight you've seen, with Joe's head snapping back, a long right-hander. Joe is perceptibly slowing down, but still he has that powerful punch. 2 minutes to go in this round. Round 12 of a 15-rounder for the heavyweight championship of the world. And your host, Pabst Blue Ribbon, mighty happy to bring you this Blue Ribbon bout. Mighty happy. Well, the action has slowed down a bit, but certainly the stirring quality of the fight hasn't. This is the slowest of the action rounds so far that we have seen. And as I've said, it's a credit to the superbly conditioned Charles, because he's weathered the blows and he's still willing to mix it in there with a dangerous puncher like Joe Lewis, who himself is in superb fighting condition. So their equipment is exactly the same and the damage is exactly the same. 1 minute to go of the 12th round. And so far, I would presume the slowest round of the fight. And it should be, from the pace these boys have kept. Joe looking for the opening, looking for the opening. Every now and then, seeing it, I think. We're looking to see exactly what damage is being done so that we can pass it on to you. This is a round where both boys, I think, are cautious and wary, looking for the spurt to the finish. A half a minute to go of round 12. And so far, a fight both boys can be very well proud of. Patterns change again. Lewis willing to lead if he can get close. Both eyes, both fighters, the left eye is completely closed. Inside the 10-second set to now. Charles striking out, scores heavily. And there's the bell, ending the 12th round. And Joe Lewis goes back to his corner, much more tired than I've seen him before. And Ezzard Charles going back to his corner, superbly conditioned as he is, evidently in good possession of all faculties as he awaits round 13. Excitement around the ringside from the press. As they look around, how do you make it? That's the answer. What do you think? Will it wind up the way we think it will? What have you got it marked on your card? So we'll look ahead to round 13, and here they go. Charles again back in the original pattern, despite the fact that his nose always draws claret from Joe's left. He's out springing around to start the round. Throughout the fight, I think the indication that Charles is willing to mix it with Joe has been one of the astounding features. Joe always willing to move in. Now the drama represents itself again. How well can Ezzard Charles fight? Well, that's been proven up to this point. The question now, the other half remains, can Joe come back? 2 minutes to go of the 13th round. The round with the hard luck number. Both boys are slipping on their punches. They're not hitting as heavily as before, and yet they're punching. Senses that Joe wants it, but the round is almost over. 1 minute to go. And now we're beginning to see the plodding cannonading. Half a minute to go. 13th round. There's the end of the round. Round 13, the crowd liked that one. Well, 13 rounds have gone by, and but two remain. And so far, both men have had exactly the same damage. Both left eyes completely closed, both noses bleeding, both scoring with telling whistling rights, both willing to mix it. Charles always slowing down a bit as the round comes to its conclusion. Joe constantly stalking, looking for that big one powerful punch to regain his heavyweight championship, which he gave up when he retired. Charles, willing to prove that he is the undisputed heavyweight champion of the world. Round 14. Retaliatory measures now. Joe Luce is bleeding rather profusely from his nostrils. It's a milling fight now, if the word milling can be used. 2 minutes to go of the 14th round. See Joe back up on that one. His eyes went slightly glazy on that one as if he were tired. Joe is tired against the ropes. He looks as if that eye is paining him, and it is. It's completely closed, has been for quite some time. But instinctively, Joe fights. Right now, this is Charles' best opportunity, so watch it. One minute to go, the 14th round. Now the comment around the ringside is, stay away, Joe, stay away, Joe. And I guess you know the dramatic quality of that. Half a minute to go of the 14th round. The Cincinnati Cobra, still springy, Joe plotting. The bell ending round 14, and both blows were struck after the bell. Joe Lewis with a right, and a retaliatory right from Ezzard Charles. Well, the next round is the big round. That's the one that tells the fight, and I don't know how you scored it, but we have it scored, and scored just well enough to have a pretty good indication of which way it's going. And the next round is definitely going to be the round. Undeniably that, and there you saw the specter of Joe Lewis. Another of the men who might not be able to come back. Certainly in that round, Cincinnati Ezzard Charles took a good lead, a commanding lead, and sprung into action, striking telling blows that caused Joe to remain against the ropes on the far side of the ring and show perceptibly that age has taken its toll. Whether or not he still has the power for one damaging punch is what the 15th round will reveal. And that's up to you to judge. We here at the ringside know the comments and know our reaction. And here's Joe Lewis for the 15th round as they shake hands, Mark Kahn separating them. In a similar situation, Walcott once did a very damaging thing when he lost the disputed decision. But here it is, Ezzard Charles fighting. Superbly conditioned, having taken the best of Joe Lewis's blows, Ezzard Charles still on his feet, driving. Lewis realizing, fighting with the great instinct of a champion. And that is not a cliche. 2 minutes to go. Final round. 15th and final round of a heavyweight championship bout here at Yankee Stadium in New York City. The seconds tick into history. Very telling right hand by Charles that time. The round half over. A good crowd here at Yankee Stadium sitting in on what has been an excellent bout. Charles willing to wrap up a fight because he thinks he has it won. Joe Louis, ready to slip behind with 50 seconds to go. Intense drama. Charles constantly flecking away, striking heavy blows at Joe Louis. Half minute to go of the fight. Fifteen seconds to go, and Charles still belting away. The fight's gone all the way, and an era ends as the bell sounds and the crowd roars its great approval. And now we're going to step into the ring for the simulcast with radio and television. So watch, and we'll pass the information. We're up on the ringside waiting, of course, for the official notation as far as the fight is concerned, as we wait for the cards from the judges Frankie Forbes and Joe Agnello and referee Mark Kahn. Standing as we are on the apron at the moment, we'll just be waiting for Johnny Addy to announce it, and then we'd like to interview those who have been the participants in the fight, including Marshall Miles, the manager of Joe Louis, and Jakey Mintz, the manager of Ezzard Charles. Should at this particular moment Ezzard Charles win the fight, it will be the first time that Ray Arcel has been in the corner of a winner. He's been in the corners of 10 men who have fought 11 fights against Joe Louis, and all of them, in a sense, were fractured. Tonight, of course, up at 12, it may be that Ray Arcel will pull it. Jimmy Cannon of the New York Post, now in Korea covering hostilities, once remarked, Joe Louis is a
ladies
credit to his
gentlemen,
race.
Ladies and gentlemen, Judge Joe Agnello scores it 12-3, favor of Charles. Judge Frank Forbes scores it 13-2, favor of Charles. Referee Mark Kahn, 10-5, favor of Charles. Winner by unanimous decision and heavyweight champion of the world, Ezzard Charles.
And now greetings to the radio audience. Joe, before you go, Joe, for an old friend, Joe Louis is going out of the ring. And I haven't been able to get him. So we'll talk to Ezzard Charles. I thought I could get Joe. We've been friends all through his fighting career. Ezzard, and Johnny Addy's holding his hands up. Well, Ray, you finally did it. Hiya, Chris. Ezzard, I'd like you to look the way you're talking. Ezzard, I'm Ted Husing. How are you tonight now?
You, I feel very well, thank you.
Well, you fought a magnificent fight, undeniably, and you were superbly conditioned, weren't you?
Well, thank you. And I'd like to give thanks to the fellows who worked with me and got me in shape for the fight and who made it possible for me to have a fight. And I'd like to express my thoughts. Well, I'd like to give thanks to God for giving me strength and courage enough to win the fight. And since I won the championship, I feel very proud about it. And I'll try and do my best to keep it as clean as the previous fellow who just stepped down, Joe Louis. I'll try to be as much of a credit to it as he was.